There must have been a bit of a flim-flam on, because they were jammed into a storage and buried frightfully crudely and rudely. If you take that little heap there, that's thought to be a form of processional cross, of which this is a reproduction. In the reproduction, we can clearly see the cruciform form and the garnets themselves enclosed in a similar way to the originals from the hoard. These two pieces are the end fittings from a sword, and this pyramid form button apparently was a button that secured the top of the scabbard to stop the sword falling out. Talking of swords, over here we've got a reproduction Anglo-Saxon form of sword called a sax. And above here, from the hoard itself, are the gold and cut garnet decorated fittings that might have fitted on a short little sax sword like that. Oh, fair takes your breath away, doesn't it? How sophisticated the craftsmanship was 1,300 years ago. The big question today is, of course, for our teams over at the auction, just how sophisticated are their skills going to be? Not so hot, I suspect. How lovely. We've trotted east from the middle of Wales to Worcestershire's premier sale room to be with Philip Sorrell. Philip.
Tim, lovely to see you.
How are you?
I'm very, very well indeed. You've brought, what's the word, eclectic mix with you, haven't you?
It's a funny old mixture, isn't it? Mm. I mean, we kick off with the reds, with these carvings. Now, if there's one thing you love, Philip, it's a lump of wood, right?
Absolutely.
So give us the lowdown on these. Indian?
Possibly. I mean, I think they're going to make between, I don't know, £50 and £70, something like that.
Right. Well, the estimate's £50 to £75. They paid £68, so they might be in line for a small bite of a profit.
Absolutely right, if things work out.
Good. Next is the Czech glass candlestick.
I think that I was born probably too soon to appreciate the finer qualities of Czech glass candlesticks.
It's a bit of a blob, isn't it?
I mean, it's the sort of thing that might, you know, we put £20 to £40 on it. What do they pay?
£50.
All right. That's not so hot then, is it?
Still, there you go. Hope springs eternal. And now we cut to something that is the cutting edge of fashionable indoor furnishing, right? A Victorian walnut armchair with clapped-out upholstery.
When it comes to being unsaleable, that is up there. And I can remember when we used to sell those for £350, £400. Now, we put £120 to £180 on it, and I think I might be being a bit generous. They've picked up a little bit over the last 6 months, but they're going to, well, what do they pay?
£175.
They're going to need to pick up a lot more, aren't they?
They certainly are. In fact, they're going to need to pick up so much, they're going to need our bonus buy, so let's go and have a look at it anyway. So, Chris, you were given a wholesome £7. What did you spend it on?
Well, here's my surprise. A pair of cloisonné vases.
What's that?
Okay, try.
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you.
Cloisonné, Chinese, the earliest cloisonné pieces were from the 14th century. They're not, let me tell you, for £7. But they're very attractive, quite new, not antiques. But what do you think?
Yeah,
really nice.
Like
elegant. Them. Really
yeah,
nice.
I thought
nice.
You would, somehow.
The damage?
Minimal.
Yeah.
Well, you see, it's made of copper and enamel, so they are a bit fragile anyway. With £7, that was a pretty tall order, let me tell you.
And you spent the £7?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Do you think we're going to get this £7 back?
Oh, plus, Amy. Of course, I wouldn't have bought them otherwise. I think
yeah,
we can reasonably expect double that.
That's not bad, then. Is plus
the
same time.
Well, we watched his lips. That's the prediction. He may double their money. For the viewers at home, though, let's find out what the auctioneer thinks about the cloisonné pots. Right then, Phil. A deep breath, methinks.
Dear me.
They filled in holes with putty.
Yeah.
And have kind of polished it over, trying to make you think that this is a perfect pair.
But he only paid what? What did he pay?
He paid £7, poor lamb.
Well, we put £10 to £20 on them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, more in fond hope than anything else. Anyway, that's it for the reds. Now for the blues. Laura and Dan, their first item is the Tommy Handley record set.
Could I just ask you?
Yeah.
David Barby wouldn't have been their expert, would he?
He certainly was.
It just, there's a bit of a likeness there, do you think?
Do you know, you're right.
It's that man again. It's a bit too Barbie for me, this.
It's like the old crack record, isn't it?
Yes. I mean, I see that at, like, £10.
Yeah.
But I've never been an Itmar fan. But David, being considerably older than you and I...
Yes, quite.
This might, in fact, be his generation.
He's kind of founded in that era, isn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. £10 to £20. They pay £25. Mm,
okay. Yes, we're moving on.
Lovely. Now, Goldscheider. Do you like that?
I sort of do and I don't. It's what people want today, isn't it?
Yes.
You know?
I think she's rather nice, you know.
Yeah.
I think she's got the Vera Lynn Goldilocks type hairdo. I mean, it's 40s, isn't it?
Yes. I mean, we put a mean sort of 40 or 60 quid on it, really.
Is that all?
Yeah. I mean, I'd do it a little bit better than that.
They paid £90. I have to admit to saying, I have seen some of this Goldscheider stuff with its paper labels like yeah. that. Make kind of mid 100 to 150.
It'll make more, yes, yeah. absolutely.
Lovely. Well, that's yeah. exciting. Now, this is a bit of meat and drink for you, because yeah. if there's one thing your sale room is renowned for, being in this part of the world and all, is this a good buy to bring here or not? Tell us about it, Phil.
Well, it probably should make more here than anywhere else. I don't know what they paid for it. It's got a Worcester mark on the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And it's...
Ready to go?
It's all ready to go for some. We've put £30 to £50 on it. What do they pay?
£70. Per double. Right. But double what you think it might be.
Well, we'll find someone with a moustache who just happens to want a memento of their trip to Worcester. I don't know if you can think of anyone.
I can't think of anybody with a moustache. Oh, a moustache.
Oh, right. No, just a thought.
No, seriously, I would say they're going to need the bonus buy, so let's go and have a look at it. Now, Laura, Dan, £185 spent, £115 goes to Mr. Barby, who is looking a little strange, I have to say, David. Have you converted to Islam? That's what I want to know.
Almost. But they're such a glammy couple that I had to buy something that was absolutely OTT.
They suit you. That's fantastic.
My colour.
Very nice.
These are typical sort of 1970s, 80s. They haven't got any great age, but they're what would be termed as white metal and paste amethyst. But they have that look, do they not?
They
I can see you on a stage and he's glittering away.
With a ball gown.
And do you wear pierced ears or clip?
I'm clip.
These are actually clip-on earrings.
Well, there we go. Fantastic. It was meant to be.
Yeah, aren't they lovely?
Well, they fitted your lobes beautifully, David, I have to say.
Look, I think he bought him for himself, really.
Well, I paid £65 for these.
OK.
I've got my hair all down.
Ah, they would definitely suit you.
Oh, look, they really look absolutely superb.
Me for her.
They do look good.
What am I going to do? I can't auction these. I need to keep them.
Do you think there's any profit in these?
I think there might be marginal. It's one of those things where I think my heart ruled my head. And I looked at those and I thought immediately, yeah.
Well, there's honesty for you, which is very, very interesting. But you never know. Other people buy things, even at auction, on compulsion, don't they?
Yes.
So we live in hope from that point
of view. We do.
All right. Right now, though, for the viewers at home, let's find out what Philip Serrell thinks about David Barby's earrings. There we go, Phil.
Gosh, thanks.
This is what you might call a typical David Barby bonus buy item, doesn't
what
it?
What did he pay for these?
Well, I think I'm going to ask you what your estimate is first.
Well, I think I've been over generous, because as Barby is a dear friend, but we put £20 to £30 on these.
And that's your friendly estimate?
Yes.
Because he paid £65. He's expecting the team, bless them, to take these, potentially, to make a profit on as a bonus buy.
Did he not get on with them? No?
I think he did. Anyway. Hardly a snowflake's chance, then, in the old proverbial.
Well, I'm not going to make any rash promises, but I think he's struggling with those, I really do.
With any luck, the team won't select him. Anyway, on that happy note, will you be taking the sale today?
Absolutely.
We're in safe hands. Wow, Amy, Sam, how do you feel just at this moment? A bit tense?
Yeah.
A bit more excited, I think.
Are you? It's lovely to come to a sale room that's absolutely crammed with folk.
It is.
And who knows, maybe they've all come here for your items.
We hope so.
They've got good taste, they have.
We sure do, Sandra. You're quite right.
The first lot up, though, are your tickers, and here they come.
Lot number 250 is the pair of carved wooden tigers. There we go. Give me £30 to start. Complete silence. £20 I have at 20, at £20 only, and 5, 30, 5, 40, 5, 50, 5, 60, 5, any more? Any more at all? At £65, 70 on the net bid, it's 75 now. At £70 on the contraption, any more at all? At £70 on the net, and I sell then at 70 and done, thank you.
Thank you. There's money in tickers.
That's good.
Plus lots of tickers.
Yeah.
Now, here comes your candlestick.
Lot number 251 is a Berenek Czech Republic glass candlestick. Bid me for that. £20 to start. Don't be so mean.
It's gone quiet.
Who's got a tenner?
No.
£10, I'm bid at 10. At £10 only, at 10, 12, 15, 18, 20.
Come on.
Come on. Go on, sir. 5, 40 now, £35 only.
Go on.
Bid at 35. There's the bid. At 35, 40, 40 bid. Yes. £40, £40, and 5, 45. At £45 and done, then at 45 and done.
Oh.
Just off, £45, bad luck, minus £5 on that, which means overall you're minus 3. But now, the armchair.
Lot number 252 is the Victorian Walnut Grandfather's Chair. There you are, bid me for that. Who's got a, I don't know, bid me £150 to start. 150, I'm bid on the net at 150. At
150? On the net,
come on. 170 on the net, 190, 210, 220, 230. What on earth do I know? 240, 250, 250, 250 on the machine, 260, 270 on the machine at £270. Is there any more? 280.
I can't believe
it. Oh, I do.
300 at 310.
£310.
Yes. 330, 340, 350.
Tim can't believe it. Oh, no, can Cyril, look at his face.
360. Any more? At £360 on the contraption and done, then at £360 and done.
Yes! £360. Well, that's 25 takes you to 200. That's 160. That is £185. You had minus 3 before, all right? You are plus 182.
Nice.
I have to say that there was a lot of sniffy chat at the auctioneer's chat. Well, there's some words to be eaten because you've proved it. You've made £185 profit on that chair, which is unbelievable. Now, what are you going to do about the bonus buy? Are you going to go with it or not? Quick,
yes,
risk
yes. Yeah, I think so.
Trust our man?
Yes.
Yes. Well, brilliant. That's a decision.
Lot number 255, pair of cloisonne ginger jars. Start me off, £20, someone. 20, I'm bid at 20. 20 bid. At £20 only at 20. Any more at all? At £20 and 5. 30 now. 30 and 5, may I? At £30 bid. Here's the bid. At £30 and I sell then at 30 and done. Thank you.
Well done, Chris.
Well done, team. Well done, team.
That's marvellous, isn't it? You've made plus £23 on that. And I congratulate you.
Thank you
very
much.
Job.
Well, thank
well
our
done,
team.
Chris.
Good.
You made the right decision there. Anyway, so that makes that 5. Yes, that means you are £205 up.
Well done.
That's not bad.
And don't you say a word to the Blues, all right?
No.
Stum.
Sad.
Okay. Look sad, that's it. That's a phenomenal result. Well
so
done.
Excited.
Well done.
3, 5, 20.
Do you know how the Reds got on?
No.
No? Good. We don't want you to know. So how confident are you feeling, Nor?
Not very, because we went with our heart, we bought things we loved, and I think that's the main thing, is if it makes a profit, brilliant, we hope it does, but we love them all.
Right.
Even the moustache cup.
Hopefully someone in the sale room will feel the same way about them that we do.
Yeah, well look at the sale room, it's absolutely jammed with
it's
folk.
Packed.
First up then, kids, is Tommy Handley, and here he comes.
The late 1940s Tommy Handley set of recordings, It's That Man Again. Were you there when they did this?
He was. Yeah. He was there when it was recorded.
Well, I £10 to start, surely.
Oh, come on.
Oh.
Who's got a fiver for Itmar?
Oh, no.
Five, I'm bid at five. Five bid. At £5 only for Itmar. At £5 only at five. Help him out, someone. Bids at the back. At £5 and only.
Oh,
any more at all? I sell then at five and done. Thank you.
Oh,
you
travesty. Travesty.
Minus 20.
Lot number 271 is the gold shiner pottery mask. Bid me £50 or £60 to start. Well, 20 I'm bid at 20 and 5, 25 and 30 and 5 and
it's
40
worth much more than that.
And 40 bid and 5, 50, 5, 60, 5, 70.
It's creeping.
5, go on, 75. Here's the bid.
at £75 and done then at £75 and done. Thank you.
£75 is what you call cheap, minus 15. Okay, there we go.
Lot number 272 is this rather lovely Worcester moustache cut. There you are, £50 to start. Well, bid me. Bid me 30 to start.
This is terrible.
Who's got £20? At £20 only. This is 25 and 30 and 5, 35 and 40. At £40 seated. Is there any more? At £40 seated.
Can I sell this?
And done. Thank you.
This is a disaster. £40 is minus 30. That's 45. 55, 65, minus 65.
Are we going to make a fortune on this one?
You're not.
Listen, you're going to risk £65 on these earrings.
Yes. Are you going to do yes, it? We're going to do it.
Oh, Lordy. We are going with the bonus by here.
Lot number 275, the pair of paste earrings.
As worn by David Barber.
Somebody bid me £50 for them. These are the new in thing. You forget all that.
They are nice.
Who's got £30? Who's got £20? Who's got £10?
Oh, I want to put
Tim's a bad influence.
His earrings. Five, I'm bid at five, eight, ten.
Yes! You want it
one more?
Go on!
£10.
There's the bid at 12. 12 bid. They won't suit you. 15. Gentleman's bid. At £15 for the earrings, and I sell then at £15 and done.
That is minus £50.
This
is a wallop. That is minus £115.
They were worn by David Barby earlier. You know,
we should have put
but it
that
was
on
not
the
announced from the rostrum.
No,
it wasn't.
I feel quite hurt.
If it had have been, I think we would have been talking
big money.
Five figures.
Big money.
At least.
Yeah, big money. Yeah, you're absolutely right.
Now listen, the score is minus 115. It might be a winning score. Don't say a word to the Reds, all right?
We won't.
Okay,
we
great. Won't. See you in a minute.
3 and 5.
Well, 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 what an extraordinary day we've had. Been chatting, you lot? You Reds and Blues?
No.
It is an amazing day of poles apart because the Blues have managed to lose £115, whereas the Reds have managed to win £205.
Yes.
So how does that happen from the same fair to the same auction room and all the rest of it? It's a question and it's the mystery of Bargain Hunt. Suffice to say, you lovely Blues, it was not your day, right?
It was our day. I'm not going to go into the antiques trade. I'm going to stick with the singing.
Well, there you go. You had a nice time, Dan.
Fantastic.
You've been good, Law?
Yeah, I loved it.
Yeah, and you've got the chance to be really close to Mr. Barby, which
very
is,
close to the
is quite something, I have to tell you. Anyway, but the victors today, you lovely Reds, who are going to have £205 coming
you.
Up here, look, was a great victory, wasn't it?
It was, yes, we were very surprised.
I mean, it was a tremendous excitement.
Yes. Brilliant.
And
love
to make it. A profit on Bargain Hunting, to go home with a profit of £205 overall is a miracle. Anyway, join us soon for some old Bargain Hunting, yes?
Yes!
First daffodils and long excited cables and candle lights on little corner tables, and still my heart has wings. These foolish things remind me of you.
That's quite exciting.
A meal for two in Brighton, Tim. What about it?
What, for me?
Yes.
Well, there's an offer for you. I thought this was going to be our third buy. I mistook the price tag. It was 20,000, not £200.
David, what did you spend all that leftover lolly on?
Something I liked him.
Yes, his porcelain moment.
It is indeed.
Let's go and model it for us, David.
Actually, David, it would fit you.
I don't think it's a trap shirt.
Oh,
no singing! We've had terrible complaints recently.
The winds of March that make my heart a dancer. A telephone that rings, but who's to answer? Oh, how the ghost of you clings. These foolish things remind me of you. Gardenia perfume lingering on a pillow, wild strawberries only 7 francs a kilo, and still my heart has wings. These foolish things remind me of you.